and go after my skin or destroy this body. Yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I see for myself, and my eyes shall behold and not another. We brought nothing into this world, and it's certain that we carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord hath taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandment of God and faith of Jesus. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, right blessed are the dead which died in the Lord. From henceforth, ye, says the Spirit, that they may rest from their labor. Amen, amen. Giving honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who is the head of our life, praising his holy and righteous name. We give honor to each of the clergy that are here today, to each and every one in their respectable place, and to my family this afternoon, in the name of Jesus. We just thank God to be here on this homegoing service. We know that sometimes it gets hard for us when things happen quickly. Amen. But we know that God is still in charge. Amen. And we thank and praise his holy and righteous name. For God is our keeper. And we know God knows exactly what is going on. Amen.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Amen. We thank you so much for coming to show your love in the name of Jesus on this day. Amen. Let us pray. Father God, most holy and eternal Father. Oh God, as we come today, we give you all praise and honor, and we thank you, God, for life, health, and strength. Even at times like this, God, we praise your holy, your righteous name. For God, we know that all power is in your hands, Father. And we come today, Lord, oh God, to lay to rest this brother. And God, we just say thank you for the time that you've given us unto us. And oh Lord, we thank you and ask that you touch the family, Lord. Give them strength. Give them the strength to endure during this time of sorrow. Oh God, we ask that you touch right now. Oh God, and we'll be ever so grateful to give your name the praise, all honor, and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Amen. Third Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pasture. He leadeth me beside the still water.
He restoreth my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemy. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen?
Amen.
Glory be to God. Thus I've read the 23rd Psalm in its entirety. Amen. Glory be to God. Amen. Amen. This time, as we go through program, I give the reflection a little bit about my brother as we know him as Buck. Amen?
Amen.
We understand his name, born given name is Evan Williamson. Amen?
Amen.
Yes, I met Brother Buck perhaps at least 30 years ago. And we always got along. Amen? Buck was a nice person. He was a respectable man, you know. He was, when I met him, you know, he's not a talkative person, amen? But he showed love. I respected him and he respected me, amen? He was a family man, a man that worked and took care of his family. And we always got along. We always talk and laugh at times, but you know that things do come to a point. This thing they call time is due all of us, amen? No matter who you are, no matter where you come from, time will catch up with us. Amen? You can outrun it. Amen? No matter how you try. Amen? But just live that God will take care of us while we're here. Amen? Amen. We know that Buck won't be missed. But, you know, God knows best. We all have a time when we shall leave this old world. Amen? And we may not know when, but we know that day is coming. Amen?
Amen.
Glory be to God. Amen. Amen. Buck is a good person, and we just thank God that it came so as a short notice unto us in the name of Jesus. Amen? But we love him, but we know God has all the plans. Amen? Glory be to God. Amen.
Amen.
At this time, we'll have a musical solo coming from Eldridge Juliet Davis, and I'll be back with the word of comfort.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Truly, I give honor to God, who's the head of my life. And to Bishop Davis and to all the clergy here today and to all of you in God's house.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. The obituary, we're going to ask you to look at the obituary and we're going to read it in solid. In the name of Jesus. He knows your name. Hallelujah, Jesus. He knows your name. He knows your name, he knows your name. Oh, how he walked with us. Oh, how he talked with us. Oh, how he tell us that we are his own. He knows your name. Thank you, Jesus. He knows your name. He knows our name. He knows our name. Oh, how he walked with us. Oh, how he talked with us. Oh, how he tell us that we are his friend.
Yeah.
He knows your name. Hallelujah, Jesus. He knows our name. He knows our name. He knows our name. Oh, how he walked with us. Oh, how he talked with us. Oh, how he telleth that we are his own. Amen. If everyone had looking over the obituary, we did solid reading for the obituary. So I'm going to go ahead and bring the selection. And the next voice you will hear will be none other than Bishop Donald Davis Sr. bringing the eulogy. Amen. Jesus said, if you lean on me, Jesus said, if you lean on me, Jesus said, if you lean on me, and I won't let you fall if you lean on me. Oh, you don't have to worry if you lean on me. Oh, you don't have to worry if you lean on me. Oh, you don't have to worry if you lean. I won't let you fall. I won't let you. He said he won't let you fall. He said he won't let you fall. I know how to hold you. I know how to hold you. He said he won't let you fall. You can trust in him. You can depend on him. He said he won't let you fall. He said he won't let you fall. He said he won't let you fall. Oh, Jesus said, if you lean on me, Jesus said, if you lean on me, oh, Jesus said, if you lean on me, he said he won't let you fall, he said he won't let you fall, he said he won't let you fall. You can trust in him. You can depend on him. He said he won't let you fall. I know how to hold you. I know how to hold you. He said he won't let you fall. Oh, Jesus said, if you lean on me. Oh, Jesus said, if you lean on me. If you lean, I won't let you fall. I won't let you fall. He said he won't let you fall. He said he won't let you fall. He said he won't let you fall. You can depend on him. You can trust in him. He said he won't let you fall. I know how to hold you. I know how to hold you. He said he won't let you fall. He said he won't let you fall. He said he won't let you fall. If you lean on him. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus said it. That you lean on him, he won't let you fall. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you.
Amen, amen. He won't let you fall. Amen. Glory be to God. Jesus will always be there for us. Amen. No matter what you're going through. Amen. No matter how low the clouds may hang. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus, you can always depend on Jesus. Amen. He promised us that I'll be with you even to the end of this world. Amen. And I know that his word is true. Amen. Glory be to God. Amen. Thank you, Elder Davis, for that great selection on today. Amen.
Amen.
We know that, that we are gathered here today for the homegoing service of Brother Williams. Amen. You know, with Brother Evander Williams. Amen. A loving friend. And is a loving father and a good friend to many. If not, we wouldn't have been here today for many of us. Even we know that some
perhaps wanted to be here and are not here this morning, this afternoon. Amen. But we thank God for each of you that are here to show your respect unto Brother Williamson. Amen.
Amen.
Glory be to God. As we begin now, let us pray. Father, we ask again in your name, Jesus, God, that you would bless me, O Father, as I come before you. Oh, God, I pray, God, that you'll give me the words that, oh, Lord, that it will comfort somebody today, Lord. It will help someone along the way. Oh, God, I give you all praise, honor, and glory, and I come say thank you for using me today in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. As we begin today in the book of Job. Job, this 14th chapter, in this first verse, it talks about man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. Life is brief and full of trouble, sickness, loneliness, disappointment, and death. Amen?
Amen.
We all, as we live, we see these things comes to us in our life. Amen? Say, but God. Amen? But God has a solution to believers who live in an unfair world. Amen?
Amen.
It's to guarantee life with him forever.
Yes.
Amen? And it's good to know that.
Oh, yes.
Now, you know that there's more to what we see here today.
Yes.
Amen? We understand that God has a prepared place
yes.
for his prepared people. Amen?
Amen?
No matter how unfair your present world may seem,
yes.
God offers the hope of you being in his present eternity.
Amen.
That means forever and ever and ever.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen?
God is good. Amen? As I wrestle with a thought for this occasion, and you know, I get in the Bible and I get on my phone and wonder what shall I say or where should I go. Amen?
Amen.
But as I read, you know, it told me that Brother Williamson, Brother Buck, has already finished his course.
Amen?
Amen, that's right.
And it told me that give an encouragement word to the others. Amen?
Amen.
Those that come to show their respect. Amen?
Amen.
And as I plundered with the thought, I came up with the topic, be ready.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Be ready. Because the same train that came and picked Brother Buck up, the same train don't stop. It may not be at my house, may not be at your house, but it don't stop. Amen? Death train will come and it will be there whether you're ready or not. Amen?
Amen.
Glory be to
That's
God.
Right.
So I said, let's be ready.
Yes.
Well, I want to talk to you coming from the book of St. John.
Yes.
St. John, the third chapter.
Yes.
I want to talk to you briefly about a man who didn't believe in Jesus
yes.
at first.
Amen.
I want to talk to you, probably familiar to most of you, Nicodemus.
Yes.
Amen?
Oh, yes.
Nicodemus was a ruler of the Sanhedrin. He was come from an elite group of Pharisees, Jews. Amen?
Amen.
But they had their own idea and they wanted to do their own thing. But Jesus, I know that Jesus come to mess up their business. Amen?
Amen.
But Nicodemus was curious and he wanted to find out who and what about Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
And so let us begin in this third chapter of St. John.
Yeah.
There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, which means teacher, we know that thou art a teacher come from God. Amen?
Amen.
For no man can do these miracles that thou doest except God be with him. Amen?
Amen?
Now he knew there was something special about Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
But Nicodemus
was of the group. They say you gotta sometimes step out from the people that you're around. Amen. Don't let your friends and your family cause you to miss heaven. Amen. No matter who they are. You, everybody got to speak and stand for their self before Jesus. Amen? Because there is coming a judgment day for all of us. All right? Well, Nicodemus, he came to Jesus by night.
Amen?
He came at night. So, you know, people think darkness can hide anything. You can't hide from God. I don't care how dark it gets.
Amen?
Jesus got eyes and he's everywhere. He's omnipresent. Amen. Meaning that he is everywhere. Nicodemus was a ruler and a member of the Pharisees, a powerful group of religious leaders. Nicodemus was searching.
Amen.
Searching, and he believed Jesus had the answer.
Amen.
Jesus is the answer. Amen. Don't matter what you're going through. If you put your trust, in Jesus.
Yes.
He is a way maker.
Yes.
He made a way for all of us.
Amen.
He woke us up early this morning.
Amen.
If it wasn't for God, the grace and mercy of God, we would not be standing here this morning.
Amen.
Or this afternoon. But God is so good unto us. He loves us in spite of, not because of.
Amen.
He did love us because he is love.
Amen.
Amen. We know that God is good.
Yes.
Then it says that Jesus had the answer, and he wanted to examine Jesus for himself.
Amen? Yes. Amen.
To separate fact from rumor. Huh?
Yes.
Yeah. You want to know the truth. That it is. And we ought to want to know the truth.
That's right.
We know that God has got, the Bible is our roadmap.
Amen.
To his heavenly home.
Amen.
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 If you study the word of God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If you read it. Now you can read it all you want. And you can strip. You can quote every scripture in the Bible.
Yes.
But if you ain't living it.
Amen.
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 You ain't doing nothing.
Amen.
Amen.
Right.
The devil know who Jesus is.
Amen.
Amen.
Right.
Yes he do. Where you think the devil came from? He's an archangel in heaven.
Oh yeah.
But he got lifted up with pride.
Yes.
And God kicked him out as fast as lightning could strike.
Amen.
You ever seen a lightning flash, brother?
Oh, yeah.
You ever seen a flash of lightning?
Yes.
For by the time you look, it's gone.
Amen.
That's how fast Satan was kicked out of heaven.
Amen.
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 Because of his pride, he was lifted up, thinking that he was going to be to exalt his kingdom like the Most High God. And you know what? He took a third of those angels with him.
Amen?
Amen. You know, but don't matter. God allowed that to happen because God knows everything.
Amen? Yes.
Thank you. Yes, we serve a God that knows everything.
That's right.
So he was afraid of being discovered. That's why he came by night.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Nicodemus made an appointment to see Jesus.
Oh,
amen.
Yes, amen.
At night. He probably got a lot more than he expected.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
If you ever been touched by God,
yes,
you'll never be the same.
Amen.
Amen. I'm not saying I read the Bible and I tell somebody that I know who God is. Amen.
Amen.
I'm talking about being truly touched by God, by Jesus. Amen. When you've been touched by Jesus, you'll never be the same.
Amen.
And let me tell you something. When a person been touched by God and they go back out into the world, you know what? The world don't want you.
Amen.
Amen. They'll talk about you like a dog. There's ain't nothing been to you to stop with.
Amen.
You say you've been saved, but I know you wasn't saved. See, that's how the devil will use you. But when you stand firm on the word of God, when you let the people see that you have been changed,
amen.
See, you got to live this thing. You got to do more than just talk the talk.
You got to walk the walk, and you got to live the life, amen, that Jesus has for us, amen. Nicodemus got more than he expected. A challenge and a new life, amen. See, once you've been touched by God, you're no more the same. I'm talking about being real, amen. See, you'll be changed from the inside out. Repent means to change, amen. When a person change, you're no more the same.
Amen.
And this is why my subject say, be ye ready.
Amen.
Amen. Be ready. Amen. When Jesus comes, because I said, he's coming back again. Amen. People dying every second. And it looked like it, people we know dying quickly. Amen. Every time I talk to someone, it seemed like somebody said, well, you know, so-and-so died yesterday, and somebody died last week, somebody else gone. Amen.
Amen.
But we don't know, but we do know that we can be ready when he comes. Amen.
Amen.
We know that he left that evening and encountered a changed man.
Amen.
Amen. Because he was touched by Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Well, let us read this last part. Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Amen?
Amen.
You must be born again. He say it should be. He say you must, except you be born again, you cannot see the kingdom of God. Amen?
Amen.
You know that there's two kingdoms. Satan got his kingdom and the devil got his. I mean, and the Lord got his. Amen?
Yes. Amen.
If you're not living for God in God's kingdom, who kingdom are you living in? Huh? It's only two. Amen? Yes. You're either living for God or you're living for the devil. It maybe is tight, but it's right.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
You know, if you don't want me to tell the truth, don't get me to preach.
Yes.
Amen? Well, I ain't got no sense. I'll tell you what thus says the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Right.
Glory be to God. You know why? I got to live by this same book, too.
Yes.
It ain't going you to preach it. That don't matter.
Yes.
God going to whip you with a double scrape if you don't do right.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
You come here trying to tell people that you live in any kind of way? Uh-uh. God ain't satisfied with that. But the word is for all of us. Amen.
Yes,
Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born again when he's old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? Yeah. No, you cannot. But you can be born again. Amen.
Yes.
Hey, God,
amen.
Jesus did this, telling him this to be saying, except a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of God.
Yes.
He was telling them because you got to be born of the Spirit. Amen.
Yes.
You got to be a changed person. This is why we must be ready. Amen. And it said that Jesus answered and said, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of the water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Amen.
Amen.
Glory be to God. You cannot enter the kingdom of God. You know that Jesus was letting us know that we must be born again. Nicodemus, he found out, except a man be born again,
yes,
of the water and of the Spirit,
yes,
he cannot enter the kingdom of God.
Yes.
The physical birth of water and the spiritual birth of the Spirit of God.
Amen.
We know that God has a prepared place,
yes,
for his prepared people. But if you want to live and see Brother Buck again, see, I don't have no heaven or hell to put Brother Williams in. I don't know what he did in his last moments, but I do know that if me and you want to see him, and if he made it in, we must be born again. Amen. I know that the God we serve is a good God, a God that will forgive us for all our unrighteousness. Don't ever think that you've done so much that God cannot forgive you while the blood is running warm in your vein. I know that God will forgive us, amen, because he is a forgiving God. His characteristic is love, church. I want you to know that God loves us so much that he gave us a way out if we just trust in the Lord. He let us know that whatever we are going through ain't ain't nothing too hard for God.
Yeah.
If we trust in him, yeah. And if you want to see Brother Buck, yeah. And if he made it into through them pearly gates, we yeah. must be ready to go back with him when he come. And I know that God is nothing but love.
Yeah.
And the greatest commandment of all is to love thy God with all thy mind, body, and soul.
Yes.
And the second verse is like unto the second, to love thy neighbor with all, to love thyself.
Yes.
And I know God's word is truth, church.
Yes.
And I want you to know this evening,
come on,
be ready. Be ready. And the time is now. Amen.
Yes, it
is. Tomorrow not promised to you. Amen.
Yes, amen.
Many people
yes.
are leaving
yes.
on short notice.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
But when you know that you know that you know
yes.
that you're saved. Yes. See, nobody know that but you and God. You know, I don't care who person is. I can't make you say, I'm the preacher. I got to do all I can to make it in. But God knows all about us. Amen. And if you want to live right before God, it's nothing but a change of heart. Amen. My brothers and sisters, I'm not here to wear your patience this evening. I want to just let you know that God is waiting on us to get right with him. Amen. And the time is now for us to do it. Like I said, time is winding up. Amen. Every day we're getting older. Like my mother used to tell me, said, boy, you know, every day you're getting closer to the grave. Amen. And you better believe it, we are. This is not our home.
Amen.
We are
our spirits having a human experience.
Amen.
But one day we'll have to leave here. And I want you to be ready. This is why I'm telling you this. I'm not telling you this just to be because it's the word of God. I'm telling you because it's God's word and God wants you to say. If he said, I pray that no man shall perish, that all men should come unto repentance. Amen.
Amen.
This is what God wants
for us. Amen.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. And we thank you. And I say to you, like I said,
Brother
Williams has already made his course.
Those of you that hear my voice this evening,
you be ready.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
If you're not ready, do it now. And you don't have to holler and scream.
It's a change of
heart
yeah.
when you get your heart right with God. If you're not ready, you always say, Father, save me.
Yeah.
I know that I'm a sinner.
That's right.
And Lord, I ask that you come into my life and be Lord of my life. Now, you can't say it just to be saying it. You got to be real about it. See, you gotta read the Bible. You got to study the Bible. And you got to live this life. Amen? And don't worry about saying that I can't live for God because it's too hard. God is a forgiving God.
Amen.
But you can't fool him. You can't think that. I'm going to say, didn't he say he'll forgive me and do anything you want to do? God, if God is our creator, don't you think he know all about us?
Oh, yeah.
Amen?
Oh, yeah.
Amen. You got to be real on this journey.
Oh, yeah.
When we make a mistake, ask God forgiveness
yes.
and get right.
Oh, yeah.
Don't go back and think you could do it over and over again and say, well,
no.
as I say that I ask him forgiveness, he say he forgive me every time. He say, God is not foolish. You can't fool me all the time. Amen. And you can't fool God no time. None of us.
Amen.
Me nor you. Amen.
Yes, amen.
I say to you, my brothers and sisters, be ready. Jesus is coming back. May God bless you and may heaven smile upon you.
Time is winding up. Mm-hmm. Time is winding up. Mm-hmm. Jesus is coming back. The blue skies and sunshine yeah. are gonna go away. There's gonna be a great judgment day. Mother, tell your daughters. Father, tell your son. They're gonna be judged according to the work they have done. Oh, let every ear hear. Why don't you? Let every ear hear. Are you listening? Jesus coming back again. Are you listening? Jesus coming back again. Are you listening? Get your house in order. Jesus coming. Are you listening? He's coming for church this evening. Are you listening? Without spot or wrinkle. Are you listening? I wonder, are you listening? Are you listening? Jesus coming back again. Are you listening? Jesus coming back again. Are you listening? Can't you see the time and the sign? Are you listening? The days are getting shorter. The days are getting shorter. Are you listening? Count the months as weeks. Are you listening? Count the weeks as days. Are you listening? Any day, Jesus coming. Are you listening? Any day, Jesus coming. Are you listening? Earthquakes in various places. Are you listening? Famine in every land. Are you listening? Can't you hear the preacher when he tells you? Are you listening? Get your house in order. Jesus coming. Are you listening? He's coming for a church this evening. Are you listening? Without spot or wrinkle. Are you listening? I wonder, are you listening? Are you listening? Jesus coming back again. Are you listening? Jesus coming back again. Are you listening? Get your house in order. Jesus coming. Are you listening? He's coming for a church this evening. Are you listening? Without spot or wrinkle. Are you listening? Oh, let every ear hear. Why don't you let every ear hear? Are you listening? Hallelujah, Jesus.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Thank you,
amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
For as much it is as pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of the departed, we therefore commit this body to the ground, earth to earth, ash to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life of the world to come. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty, to judge the world and the earth and the sea, shall give up their dead and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his glorious bodies, according to the mighty works whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, from henceforth blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. Even so faith, the spirit, they rest from their labor. Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Let us pray the Lord's Prayer in unison. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Amen. Benediction. Now may the grace of God and the communion of the sweet spirit may it rule, rest, and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen.
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 And the church, we thank God for the life, for touch of lives for all of us here. Thank God so much for his memory and always be in our hearts. But we thank God so much for this family that lives beyond. We pray God bless upon them as they do the days and the days ahead. Thank God to our ministers, best neighbors for coming. It's such a beautiful, humble message for this family. And to the many friends who came to show love. got a big opportunity to spend with you. As we prepare ourselves for a final viewing, thank you, trust in God, pray for his family, and also thank you so much for allowing us to serve you. Again, thank you for your company.
Amen.
My soul is resting. Ain't that a blessing? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm free. I am free. Praise the Lord. I'm free. I'm no longer bound, and no more chains holding me. My soul is resting. Ain't that a blessing? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm free. I am free. Praise the Lord, I'm free. I'm no longer bound, and no more chains all in me. My soul is resting. Ain't that a blessing? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm free. I am free. Praise the Lord, I'm free. No longer bound, and no more chains holding me. My soul is resting. Ain't that a blessing? Praise the Lord.
But hold on, better days are coming. It can be rough in this world. I know it ain't easy, but hang on in there. I know better days are coming. You seem good. You seem bad. You've been happy and sad. But just remember that better days.